Hello, Tim here again. It's another brew day. Today I'm going to do some stuff I've never done before. Same technique, same brewing, but a different kind of beer, and I'm going to be doing a little bit different method. I'm going to make a PartiGyle. Now what a PartiGyle is you take the same grain and you do two mashes with the grain, or actually two runnings of the water through the grain. I'm going to make a barley wine, and then that will come out of the first runnings, and then I'm going to make just a pale ale out of the second runnings, and I'm going to probably put Saison yeast in the pail and see if I can get a little bit different of a flavor on it. So anyway, it's going to be a long day, because when you do a PartiGyle and you have to do a second mash, essentially, maybe not quite as long as a primary mash, it does take a little longer, because I'm going to have two boils going at the same time. Luckily I got enough equipment, I'm going to be able to do two boils at the same time. The first boil with the barley wine is probably going to go for a good 90 minutes. I need to get the specific gravity up pretty high, so I have the alcohol content at the end down there, or up there where I want it. Anyway, so let me show you what we got going here. I just finished weighing my grain, and I'll come over here and show you what I got here. If you look, there's my scale. Total grain bill is going to be about, that works out to be about 22 pounds. The bucket weighs about 2.5 pounds, and I've got 18 pounds of two row, and a pound or pound and a half of some other various grain. Real quick, go over what I got here. Here's a recipe. I doubt it's going to focus in, but 18 pounds of pale malt, pound and a half Vienna, pound of biscuit, pound of caramel crystal 120, and 4 ounces of special B. Later on, I'm going to add in some hops, and I'm going to put 2 ounces of progress in at the initial boil, and an ounce of fugal at 30 minutes, and I believe another ounce of fugal at flame out. No, actually 2 ounces of fugal at flame out, or thereabouts. Down on the left here, I got my grain mill, and I'm not sure that I've ever shown my grain mill in a video. Maybe I have. Basically, it's a Corona mill, and if you see, I've got it mounted on a 2x4 that's screwed into the side of the bucket here. Get my arm out of the way. Screwed into the sides of the bucket, and I've got the mill itself spaced apart with a couple washers. I took a feeler gauge, like you would set the gap on spark plugs, and aligned that to, I believe, 0.0297 inch. On top of the bucket, I got a hole cut there, so this will go in, and that does a great job of keeping the dust contained within the bucket. When you're grinding with one of these mills, dust and grain bits go everywhere, so that'll keep it nice and in there. So anyway, I'll get started on that. I won't spend a whole lot of time filming it. All right, I'm going to stop right now, take a look inside the bucket, and see how much we've got ground up. See, it's about halfway up. I'm going to go ahead and dump that off into another bucket. And if you look, Got a pretty decent crush on that. Anyway, I'm going to turn the camera off, finish this up, and come back a little further along in the process. All right, I'm done grinding the grain. Got my mash water all set the right temperature. Just getting ready to dough in. Adding all my crushed grain into the water. Spoon here. I've got a lot of grain here, so it's going to really suck up this water. I'm going to stir it as I pour it. I don't want any dough balls. Pretty well doughed in, and I'll get my mash timer going here. Now, one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use my rim system up here and recirculate a little bit. And since I want to get every bit of gravity I can out of here. Set my rims up. I got my spinning sparge on here, and it's just barely gonna fit above the grain. Hopefully that won't clog when I'm going. Let's see if this is moving a bit. Look in, and it looks like right now I'm at about 146, which is a good one. Hand over here, show you what the sparge arm looks like. Oh, there went my broken scoop. And I'm going to slow that down a little bit. Anyway, we'll let this go for a good hour, and I will periodically check it. And right now I'm just going to cover it, keep all the heat I can in it, and looking down here at my temperature. Okay, about 146, which is good. I want to mash at about 152-153. I can get that up there pretty quickly. Okay, I've been mashing now for about 15 minutes, and the rims has been running, and right now I'm in perfect temperature range, about 153-154. Quick overview of the system. I do have a recirculating infusion mash system. It means I got a heating tube up there, and that long tube has a heating element in it. On the bottom is the electrical box. Wort flows in the bottom, goes past the heating element, and comes out the top. And there's a temperature sensor right there at the top. And then the wort travels back down and goes into the spinning sparge arm. Over here at my brew controller, The left-hand side controls the rim, and it's set at 154 degrees. And it's gonna keep that temperature right there. The right-hand side controls my hot liquor tank right now. And then to the right of that, it's a knob that's gonna control my boil kettle later. But everything's working as it should. Up here in my hot liquor tank, my kegel, you see I actually do recirculate the water in it so that it heats more evenly. And I actually have a mirror up above it. You can see into it. And see the heating element inside there in the mirror. And then the out tube coming from the front. Anyway, yeah, put the lid back on. There's my system. There's the chugger pump that I use to recirculate the mash. I found that my little pump here tended to get clogged easier, so I like using the chugger for the mash recirculation, and the little pump is great for just moving liquid. Okay, I'm just getting ready to mash out. I've added a couple gallons of water to my mash tun to raise the temperature up. Set my rims to 168 degrees, so we'll get a nice mash out temp. According to my thermometer here, I'm at about 162, 163. So we'll get a few give it a few minutes to raise up to 168, and then I'll start draining it into my boil kettle. I need to get about 8 3/4 gallons of liquid, and hopefully I'll hit my gravity. I haven't checked the gravity yet, where I am pre-boil at this point, but I'll check it when I get my volume in the kettle. And once I'm in the kettle, we'll get the boil started on this part of the PartiGyle, and then I'm going to add some water. Another 5 gallons or 6.5, 7 gallons of liquid out of that, and we'll get a second boil going. It's going pretty well. Time's flying, so we should be ready to go here shortly. All right, I've finished my first runnings, the first water through the grain. Got about 8.5 gallons, just like I expected to. My gravity was a little low. It came in at about 155, 160. I was hoping it was going to be closer to 170, but if I need to, I'll just keep boiling it. I then added the amount of water I want to get out of my grain to my grain for the second runnings, and got that up to temperature, and it's running through the rims right now. I added some Crystal 60 to it and a little bit of roasted barley. Took the gravity reading a bit, and it was only at about 130 that time. So I went ahead and crushed a couple pounds of 2-row and added that to it. I'm going to let it recirculate for 45 minutes or thereabouts to get some conversion out of the sugars in the 2 pounds of 2-row. And I shouldn't get anything like that out of the crystal or the barley. But anyway, we're moving right along. My boil just started, just hit the hot break, foamed up a bunch, went down. I'm getting ready to have my hops first edition. Now my first hop edition, I'm making this an English barley wine. So I'm gonna add 2 ounces of UK Progress. And UK Progress is an English hop that, from what I understand, when they originally developed it, they were going to use it as a replacement for Fuggles. And so I'm going to add this now, and then later I'm going to add some Fuggles. Anyway, I'll stop back when we have some more progress. All right, I'm a lot further along. I've already boiled down almost all what I need to boil out of my first runnings for the barley wine. I've got my second runnings, which was essentially a second mash with some additional grains. Not much additional grain, a little bit for flavoring and gravity. But that's running here in my second kettle. My second kettle's kind of screwy in that it's set up to run 220 volt heat sources. I got a heat stick hanging on the side there, and then over on my controller, I've got the middle PID set at 120 volts so that I won't blow my circuit while the other one's boiling. I can kick it up to 240 if I need to. But anyway, it's, you can kind of see there, I got a little bit of foam starting to build up on top, so I'll be hitting the boil pretty soon. It's about 180 degrees right now. Move the camera back here, sorry about the jiggling. This is really turning out to be a busy day. Getting everything out, getting everything set up, moving things around so I have room for everything. It's quite a task to do a PartiGyle all by yourself, but I think it's gonna be good. I've tasted both worts and they both taste pretty decent. I'm sure once they ferment, they're gonna taste really good. But anyway, there's where we stand at this point in time. I'm going to start in a little bit recirculating my barley wine so that I can run it through my chiller and sanitize the chiller. Then I'll be ready to go when it is time to chill. So there you go. Okay, just did flame out on the barley wine. Added my last hops addition in a little under 10 minutes and some Irish moss for clarification later. I'm letting the wort whirlpool for a little while. It's not really spinning fast, it's just going around about like this. And I'll bring the camera over. But anyway, when I drain it, there'll be a lot of crud in the middle, a little bit of trub left over, maybe some hop dust, possibly some of the Irish moss. Anyway, that'll be good. My second batch here, since I instead of the 120, and it's just starting to boil, so I gotta keep a close eye on it. I don't want it to boil over. And in fact, I'm gonna turn it down. Okay, I just added my first hops addition. And I got a good boil going here. That's on the PartiGyle batch. And then over here, if you look, you can see a little bit of the whirlpool going on. Spinning around there. I got my hop screen hanging there, it was dripping off. But that's down to about 120 degrees right now, which is probably just fine for me to start transferring it into a fermenter, because it'll easily get down to ground temperature coming out on the other end. And again, this thing's going really good. I'm going to turn it down a little bit. You want a good rolling boil to get all the proteins and the chemicals that you don't want in your beer out, but I don't want it boiling over, and I need to make it last 45 minutes, and I'll boil off a gallon an hour. So, and I've only got about a gallon worth of space to boil off right now to hit my final gravity and numbers. So. Quick display of my chiller. If you look over to the left here, there's my counterflow wort chiller. Water comes in the bottom left there, goes through the coil, and then comes out here at the top. Wort, hot wort, gets pumped from the bottom of my kettle through the chugger pump, and hot wort goes into the bottom in the inside copper tube, comes out at the top and back out. So what's happening is the hot wort goes in at the same spot that, excuse me, the hot wort's going in the top, so it meets up with the warmer water coming out, but it equalizes once it gets to about the middle of the coil. It meets up with cold water coming from the bottom, and by the time the hot wort goes from the top to the bottom of the coil and comes out the other end, it's chilled down and reaches an equilibrium with the coil. Now, if I didn't want a whirlpool, I could easily just drain through the counterflow wort chiller right into my fermentation bucket and I'd be good. But I want a whirlpool and get as much crud out as I can. Anyway, there we go. I'm filling up the fermenter bucket. And looks like I'll probably get close to 5 gallons of wort for the barley wine, which is right about what I expected. We'll take a look at the effects of the whirlpool and when it gets down a little further. All right, here's the inside of the boil kettle. You can see up in the top the heating element, and there's the exit tube and the whirlpool arm down there. But let's see what happens when we get to the bottom. See right there in the middle, that's all the like a circular crud thing right in here. That's gonna take everything from the outside and leave a lot of that behind. You don't want to leave a lot of that liquid behind. It will settle out in the fermenter, but it doesn't hurt to get as much crap as you can out. Choke the kettle a little bit. Just about done. What's left isn't worth dealing with. And more stuff's coming down. So, lost maybe a quart into the fermenter, or into the boil kettle, not going to the fermenter. Still plenty of stuff stuck to the middle there. It is sucking some of it in, unfortunately, but that's just small particles, and those will settle out in the bucket. Yeah. Okay. That's it. Pump off. Now we're going to empty the hoses. Okay, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean out the lines. I'm going to get that pump strained off and just pull this. I'm just going to take and blow some air down the middle of it. I've got an oilless air compressor here. And that's it. Got all this. The liquid out, and my fermenter came up to right about here, right at the 5 gallon mark, which is just great. That's pretty much exactly what I wanted it to be. Now what I'm going to do is hook this counterflow thing up to my other boil kettle, and we'll be using it to chill it sometime soon in the next half hour or so. That I'm good. right, I'm all done except for the cleanup. I got a little over 5 gallons of barley wine and about 5 gallons of Saison pale ale. So it'll be a German Saison. So worked out pretty good. The barley wine came in at 1.102. And it looks like the Saison came in at 1.042. So got good results from our PartiGyle Brew. Got a lot of cleaning left to do. Still got a lot of cleaning left to do. Then I gotta aerate the wort and put my yeast in, but that's not that big a deal. I got yeast going over here, and I'm gonna throw a package in with the starter I've already got going, SO4 and the barley wine, and then I'm gonna use some Belle Saison in the Saison, in the Saison pail. So, that's it for today's brew day. Thank you for watching. Hope you learned a little bit of something. It's been a lot of work. I've been at it now for almost 8 hours. And I still got a good half hour, 45. It's a whole lot more work. But I got twice as much beer, so that's great. Take care. Cheers. Well, it's been about 2 weeks since the initial brew day, and I've had both the Saison and the barley wine fermenting now, and they've attenuated about as far as they're going to. I believe I started at 1.102 in the barley wine and about 1.5, I think, on the Saison. Well, I'm going to take one final reading and then I'm going to start cold crashing both of the batches. So let's see how we did. Down here I've got my fermentation chamber, refrigerator. It is on a controller. I don't know if you can see it, but and I've got it set right now at just a little under 78, or excuse me, a little under 70 degrees, around 68. Now, when I ferment, I like to use buckets with spigots, just because it's real easy to take the gravity reading off of them. So let's go into the other room here. As you can see, got the hydrometer going here. Let's see where we ended up. I tested this yesterday and it was right at 1.020. And I'm going to look right now, and I'm not sure if you can see this, I probably can't, but it's right at 1.020 still. Let's see if I can pull it in a little closer. You'll notice I don't believe we'll be able to get a good focus on it. There you go. Right there, 1.020. So my gravity is stable on the barley wine. And it's ready to cold crash. Okay, I'm in my other fermentation closet. Fermentation space, it is a closet. This keeps at a constant temperature right around 70 degrees, so pretty good for fermenting. As I mentioned with the barley wine, I started that out actually in the mid-60s, let it go in the mid-60s for about a week, and then slowly cranked it up to about 69. This has been at 70 the whole time. I'm gonna take the gravity a bit. All right, well, here we go. Let's take it over to the keyser and see what it looks like. Okay, it's had some time to settle down a little bit. We'll take a quick reading. Let's see, it looks, last time I checked it, it was about 1.06, I believe. This 1.0 right there. And sure enough, that's where it stayed. Let's see if I can get in a little closer on it. Okay. All right. Yeah, you can't really tell. I'm looking at the focuser. Okay, right there. Well, it's 1.06. Kind of hard to see from here, but... Well, both the gravities for both beers have stayed the same now for plenty of days. Okay, well, there you go. Both beers came out pretty decent as far as the attenuation. Again, I started out at 1.102 with the barley wine and ended up at 1.020. That works up to be an ABV of around 10.9. The Saison, I started at 1.042 and ended up at 1.006, and that works out to be an ABV of around 4.6%, I believe. 4.7% according to Beersmith. So pretty decent brew day, getting 10 gallons of beer out of one batch of grain, and 10 gallons of two different kinds of beer with the PartiGyle system. The barley wine tastes really delicious, I'm sure, after I bottle it and let it age for 4 to 6 months, it's going to be awesome. The Saison tastes really good too. I'm sure I'll be able to drink that in 3 or 4 weeks. I'm going to start cold crashing both of the fermentation vessels. The one that's in the refrigerator, I'll just turn the temperature controller down, and I'm going to set it about 39 degrees so that it'll crash, let it sit in there for a couple days. The other Saison, I'll stick in another refrigerator. I don't have quite as accurate a temperature control in it because it's just a refrigerator, and it should come down to around 38 degrees, 37 degrees within a while, a couple days, and get all the suspended stuff out of it so that I'll get a nice clean bottling. I'm going to probably keg the Saison for the most part. I'll bottle some of it, and I'm definitely going to bottle all of the barley wine. So, looking forward to it. Thank you for watching. Cheers.